Ladies and gentlemen, coming to the ring, weighing in at 205 pounds, from Fork River, Manitoba, Michael Allen Richard Clark.
I was a 150-pound nerd. Look at me now. The long-term goal with wrestling, obviously, make it to the big time. So everyone wants to be remembered as a famous wrestler, right? A ton of people I'm going to prove wrong. Definitely.
Make my words, I'm gonna get my grade 10. I was thinking you. I chose orange because it's like, hey, you remember the guy wearing orange? Yeah, man, I remember that guy. Did some pretty cool shit, or whatever they have to say, as long as they remember, you know? So many guys wear black and red and whatever else. I mean, they don't. I wanted to be different. The switch from me to Michael Allen Richard Clark. I don't know, as soon as I go out there, I guess. Maybe just before, trying to get myself pumped up. Get a little warmed up. Typical, a little bit nervous, but that goes away as soon as you walk out there.
The man with the longest name in professional wrestling, Michael Allen Richard Clark.
Sort of dark, but it's bright around the ring. You know, it's a big arena. What do you feel? A sense of accomplishment. This is what you've been working towards. if I was still Michael Allen, Richard Clark, I'd try again and get that chant to go around the arena. Michael Allen, Richard Clark. Michael Allen, Richard Clark. Michael Allen. Seeing like rows upon rows upon rows of people.
Home to some of the craziest personalities I've ever encountered in my life. It's a circus. This is the very roots of HIW. You don't have a show unless you have guys who know what they're doing, and this is where they learn how to do it. It's a great big dysfunctional family sometimes. It's we're all friends, but I mean you have your infighting here and there.
There's a fine level of people supporting you and competing with you, but there's also a fine level of support and jealousy too. I mean, I haven't really noticed or paid attention or really experienced it.
It's a business based on ego and everything else, but I mean, at the end of the day, we're still all people.
The hours are flexible, so I can fit it around wrestling. The managers are reasonable. Hey, I got a wrestling show this day. I need this day off. Wrestling doesn't really mean anything. It sort of is, you know, this is your life, if you will. Everything's kind of focused around wrestling, even going to work. Like, I'm working to make money so I can go somewhere else for wrestling. Like, it's everything kind of centered around this. The relationships that I keep with people. You know, if I don't want you around, it's because I probably think you're going to be some sort of drama that might hold me back. And I'm not going to let anything do that. Well, if you get too attached to somebody or they're just stressing you out for some reason, and if you get stressed, you can't go work out or go to the gym or whatever, you know. You trim the fat. You cut out people you don't want. You keep a very short list of people you want around.
The goal is to try and get signed, and I was, I believe, a couple times came very close.
And here he comes, Wavell Star, one of the fastest rising stars in the business today.
He is one of the top prospects in the world today and one of the top heavyweights in Canada, obviously in great condition. I want to take my hat off for a second to the referee.
But never actually did come to fruition where I ended up getting to put ink to paper. First Nation sensation, the feature presentation, God's greatest creation, Wavell, the stud of the stable, Star.
match. Okay, so just stay calm. What one thing we could do to improve on last night is to slow down a bit. I know that sometimes like, when you don't know what's next, your natural reaction is to like want to go do something rather than that, just concentrate on your presence and slow down. Yeah, we'll just slow right down. There's no need to rush anything. One thing at a time. Okay.
Show them was that it wasn't necessarily the moves that you do when you're out there, it's the story that you tell. And so basically I kept the match very basic, very simple, and I wanted to show them that the crowd will still follow it. He's at that stage where he's going to start getting his footage and sending it out to the offices and stuff like that. But really, to go out there and tell a good story and to get the crowd engaged is what it's all about, and we did that. Certainly a lot that has to go with it is going to be luck and timing. So basically he's got to do whatever he can to make his chances improve.
Would I ever take steroids? Depends how much money you give me. Most people would like to say no, but I mean, if somebody walks up to you with a six-figure contract, who's going to say no?
Looking back on it, it's tough. I spent a lot of time when I was training in Calgary, sleeping on buddies' couches, eating tuna out of a can, because you're back and forth all the time, trying to work out on the road. He's got so much to learn about all that stuff. But he certainly has the potential.
Canada's pretty hard when you're an indie wrestler. There's greener pastures elsewhere. I'm not going to be here forever. I don't ever intend on that. I want to leave as soon as possible, really.
Roadhouse type character. It's like the loudmouth guy will have a beer, or you know, drink, sit down and have a drink, and then go and have a fight, and then come back and finish the drink, I guess. When I first started, when I was 18, I was the young upstart. I was kind of making some waves with certain people, and then it just kind of faded away. I didn't take the steps that I should have. Should have just did it, not just hesitating, and then letting people kind of get it in your head that you're not good enough to make it that far.
I'm not scared of chasing it too far, no. Because I at least I'll know, even if I chased it and failed, it's like, hey, I gave it a shot. But I don't really see that as being an option anyway, so.
I wanted to make it all the way to the WWE. 18 years in the business, I still set up that ring.
Young girls and older women, that's who Michael Allen Richard Clark appeals to. Young girls and older women. Bon Jovi and, you know. Young, decent looking guy, I suppose. So, clean cut, clean shaven. Yeah, that's who he appeals to. I don't know, I think I am just a clean-cut good guy. Like, I stand up for what's right and do what's good, you know? Like, try and do the good thing, I guess you could say. Like, I guess if people get behind that, then we have some good people in the audience. That's what it's all about, is making them believe in characters, so. That's what wrestling's all about.